Welcome to the TeamForge 7.1 What's New training video. In this video, we'll introduce the new features, functionality, and improvements included in the 7.1 release of CollabKnit TeamForge. TeamForge 7.1 is a progression of CollabKnit's commitment to scaling agile, to tool and process neutrality, and to easing the transition to enterprise-wide software development. This version further extends the open, social, and collaborative capabilities of the TeamForge platform for the enterprise, while continuing as the industry's only federated ALM platform, integrating distributed ALM and collaboration tools onto a central community architecture. TeamForge 7.1 now ships with TeamForge Orchestrate 1.1, an add-on for CollabKnit TeamForge that reduces software delivery cycle time by integrating TeamForge with popular build, release, and deploy solutions. TeamForge with Orchestrate connects disparate tools, teams, and activities, producing cross-functional associations and visual traceability throughout the software development lifecycle while delivering central visibility and control for the enterprise. This powerful combination enables development, operations, and lines of business to leverage the TeamForge platform to automate and orchestrate all the activities of the software development lifecycle. TeamForge 7.1 includes enhancements for speed and productivity, improvements in navigation and click streams, and support for the latest versions of the most popular open-source enterprise tools. CollabKnit TeamForge 7.1 includes many features and enhancements focused on customer-driven and architecture improvements to make the user experience smoother and more robust, and to support the latest in related integrated applications. Customer-driven improvements include enhancements to agile features, usability improvements, and expanded lifecycle metric reporting. Architecture improvements include updates to newer versions in many third-party integrations to bring TeamForge users the advances and new features of those newer integrated applications. Some of the more noticeable improvements in support of agile development occur in the planning board. With the improved agile features included in CollabKnit TeamForge 7.1, you can quickly add and edit artifacts in the planning board view, view the card count and planning folder capacity of a selected planning folder, and refresh individual swim lanes to see very recent artifact updates without leaving the planning board. To quickly add a new artifact, use the plus sign located at the top left of each planning folder swim lane. Select the tracker type and add a title and description. You'll still need to edit the artifact to add additional details, but using this method allows you to create artifacts quickly within the context of the board view to get an immediate visual of the work loaded into the planning folder. In addition to adding new artifacts, you can also edit artifacts directly in the planning board view. Click the Edit icon next to the artifact ID to launch a pop-up artifact editor. Changes can be made and submitted without leaving the planning board. After adding or editing an artifact within the planning board, TeamForge helps to identify those additions and changes by briefly highlighting the cards affected. Of course, the changes made to artifacts in the planning board view are reflected in the planning folder view as well. The new Refresh button located at the top right of each swim lane will update the selected planning folder so that you see the most current updates, including those initiated by other users while you've been working. In TeamForge 7.1, metadata about the selected planning folder has been added to the top of each swim lane. Story points, capacity, and the number of cards listed are now displayed. As artifacts in the planning folder swim lanes are edited, these numbers will update to reflect those changes. In TeamForge 7.1, table filters have been improved to include a multi-select capability. You can now select one or more values for your filters by checking multiple values in the filter value drop-down list. This offers you flexibility in your filtering by allowing you to filter on multiple values. Changing the tracker type for an artifact can now be done directly on the artifact edit screen, as opposed to the previous method of cutting and pasting between trackers. When editing an artifact, the tracker value is now a drop-down, allowing for a new value to be selected and saved. This greatly reduces mouse clicks, as all editable artifact metadata can be changed and updated directly from the artifact edit screen. In TeamForge 7.1, a contextual artifact edit menu option has been added after each artifact ID in the planning folder artifact list. This contextual edit menu displays on hover and allows you to manage relationships for an artifact. In addition to the new features and enhancements covered so far, other notable usability and user interface improvements have been made in TeamForge 7.1. CollabNet TeamForge 7.1 utilizes an underlying technology that improves page display on both iPad and iPhone. TeamForge 7.1 provides a method of pointing to a repo manifest file on a public Garrett server, which will, in turn, import all referenced Garrett projects into TeamForge. Once done, you can point repo to the new manifest file and it will use the TeamForge-hosted Garrett repositories from this point on. It also allows you to specify a prefix and TeamForge project for all imported Garrett projects, making it possible for you to import the same public Garrett server more than once into the same TeamForge-managed Garrett server, a feature unique to CollabNet's offering. TeamForge writes a lot of data to log files, and while you've always been able to tune the verbosity of those logs, such a change required a restart of the application to take effect. Now, in TeamForge 7.1, you can manage log verbosity on the fly via the web UI without requiring a server restart. TeamForge 7.1 now uses HiCharts instead of Flash, so you no longer have to download the latest Flash player to view your project's reports, charts, and metrics. Pitchfork is a simple project exporter-importer which has been used to import templates into new instances of CollabNet TeamForge, and which now allows the inclusion of report configuration data in that export-import process. Two new reports have been added to the list of lifecycle metrics reports available for inclusion on your project homepage, a burndown chart and a burn-up chart. The steps to create both are similar. Just select the report type and click on the next button. Follow the guidance of the wizard and complete each report, identifying the report data, output type, and layout of the chart. There are two types of burndown charts, release burndown by sprint and sprint burndown. The release burndown by sprint chart tells the story of how much work is left to be done versus how much was allotted for each sprint within the release. With time along the x-axis, the amount of work or backlog measured in story points is on the y-axis. Average velocity per sprint in the release can be displayed with the burndown chart. The report can be configured for a selected sprint planning folder to see its progress on a day-to-day basis. The sprint burndown chart displays results based on remaining effort data, telling the story of how much work is left to be done versus how much time is left, pointing to the real decrease in backlog. With the wizard, your output is controlled by the criteria you enter. You can choose to report on selected planning folders and trackers. You can choose the type of output, the layout, and the title. And your reports can be configured to ignore weekends or specific days when calculating burndown. The burnup report shows the effort trends for the chosen planning folder or tracker ID. And just as we saw with the burndown charts, you control the report data, the report type, and layout using the wizard. And you can also select your effort units, either points or hours, when configuring your report. This chart includes a trend line to show the planned work scope change between a release's start and end dates. In other words, the start and end dates of the release's planning folder. We can also include a trend line in the chart that forecasts when planned work might be completed depending on the average rate of progress or velocity. TeamForge 7.1 also includes a number of architecture and integration improvements. 7.1 has upgraded to support ReviewBoard 1.7.17. This also brings an enhanced relationship between ReviewBoard and Orchestrate. Unlike the ReviewBoard 1.6 polar-based adapter, this 1.7 Plus adapter is a proper ReviewBoard adapter which works with the current release of Orchestrate 1.0.2. This new adapter is packaged as a Python egg for easy installations and provides a web-based configuration for Orchestrate credentials and keys, similar to our other adapters. TeamForge 7.1 now supports Subversion enhancements, moving from 1.7 to 1.8, a major version upgrade which is more agile-friendly with its ease-of-use improvements and better merging capabilities. CollabNet has updated its training, services, and support for Subversion 1.8 as well. Postgres has been upgraded to 9.2.4, which offers better security in many areas of the open source database. Searching and indexing has been improved with the upgrade to Lucene 4.4. And with the update to Garrett 2.6.1, TeamForge now includes all of the additional features found between Garrett 2.1.8 and 2.6.1, including usability features like the rebase change button, streamlined release workflow, commit message editing from the UI, file level comments, and so forth. For more details on these and all of the other new Garrett features, visit garrett-training.scmforge.com. To support all of the features and enhancements we've discussed, and to maintain the efficacy of TeamForge, many underlying platform improvements have been made. Many enhancements have been made for searches, including optimized search indexing for artifacts and documents, replacement of the binary document indexer Stellant.io with Tika, and the inclusion of a multi-threaded search handler. Changes to the integration of the Git Garrett installer with the TeamForge installer, enhanced session handling, and the upgrade to JDK 1.7.0.21 and JBoss 7.1.1 are also among the platform improvements included in TeamForge 7.1. Thank you for attending this CollabNet TeamForge 7.1 New Features and Enhancements training course. To explore additional learning opportunities for TeamForge, please visit the CollabNet training page.